What we're seeing here in the auto industry over the last couple of months is a classic supply and demand situation. Since they have not enough supply of new cars, a lot of people are going to salvage yards like this one, trying to keep their old ones running just a little bit longer.
And this motor actually is going to be going to Texas.
Chris Brackey has been in the salvage business all his life. He's the sales manager at Highway 101 Auto Salvage in Savage, and he's never seen so much demand for parts.
So that particular engine was sold to a customer here in Minnesota.
A demand that started more than a year ago when the pandemic first hit and people lost their jobs and started getting stimulus money.
It's been a huge increase in that do-it-yourself person.
Fixing up cars with their spare time to earn a little extra money. And now on top of that, it's the chip shortage that's sending more customers searching for parts.
Just trying to get things put together to get cars back on the road. But there's a lot of parts that people can't find or source, and this is the only avenue for them.
But it's not just parts. They're also seeing a huge demand for whole cars and trucks. Cars and trucks that were set to be scrapped.
Oddly enough, different countries, particularly Africa, Kenya, Nigeria, and Liberia, and they're exporting cars.
Because they can't find enough new ones in their own country.
Not only are they taking these cars and putting them in a container and shipping them all the way back, they're actually cutting them up and then putting them back together at their destination.
Because you pay less in taxes and fees to ship parts of cars versus the whole thing. I guess it's like they say, if there's a will, there's a way.
People trying to be much more resourceful.
So long story short, if you have an old car laying around that you don't want to use, you'll probably get more money for it, and the demand for that car is probably higher than you were expecting. Gordon Severson, Carol 11 News.